Ryan Sturran. We best keep to our knitting. It's time to either run the table or go home empty. Ryan's got the genetic key to Rapture. We get that from him and we get out of this hellhole. We don't, then you and I are ghosts. Now would you kindly head to Ryan's office and kill the son of a bitch? It's time to finish this.
Welcome to the Circus of Value!
I say Cohen's lost his touch, if you knew him well. He used to believe in work, the struggle. And now, he rots in that Neverland, waiting for someone to come and tell him he's still got it. I suppose that's why he let you live. Taste it, can't you? Andrew Ryan. Chosen the spot for you on the wall yet. and let me know if you have a preference.
I never killed a man, let alone a mate. But this is what things come to. I don't know if killing Mr. Ryan will stop the war, but I know it won't stop while that...
I had to go jungle style with that filthy ape for 3 weeks, but he finally spilled the beans on how to get to Andrew Ryan. Generate a sympathetic overload in harmonic core number 3. That's simple. Now all I gotta do is figure out what the hell a sympathetic overload is, and for that matter, a harmonic core number 3. Piece of cake for an electrical engineer. Too bad I designed Lady's shoes. Gonna go see the grease monkeys left alive in heat loss monitoring. See what I can shake out of their trees.
I like all parasites who ever tried to walk in stolen shoes. I'd explain the science that renders what you're trying to do impossible, but that would be like playing Mozart for a tree frog.
What is the difference between a man and a parasite? A man builds, a parasite asks, "Where is my share?" A man creates, a parasite says, "What will the neighbors think?" A man invents, a parasite says, "Watch out, or you might tread on the toes of God."
Go make this harder than it needs to.
Run!
Returning to her lungs, the shops reopening, the schools humming with the thoughts of young minds. My city will live, my city will thrive. When that day comes, we'll use your tombstone for paving time.
You're only making it worse!
Only making it worse!
strikes me that Fontaine wasn't overly inconvenienced by his own demise. On New Year's Eve, these wretched splicers come streaming out of the poorhouses and stormed the proverbial barricades. The dead rot in the streets, and Johnny and Janie Citizen are lined up around the block for plasmids. Anything to help fend off the rabble.
Have any idea there's a war on? If you don't follow proper maintenance of those big daddies, they burn through those R34s like them eat apple berries, go through penicillin. I've got Atlas's goons hitting us non-stop and two dead mechanics just this week. We need to control costs. If I wanted to deal with amateurs, I would have stayed on dry land.
Strikes me that Fontaine wasn't overly inconvenienced by his own demise. On New Year's Eve, these wretched splicers come streaming out of the poorhouses and stormed the proverbial barricades. The dead rot in the streets. Johnny and Janie Citizen are lined up around the block for plasmids. Anything to help fend off the rabble.
Whipping his nose.
Oh. You
blood in the streets. Of course, have some chosen to destroy themselves with careless splicing, undeniable. But I will make no proclamations. I will dictate no laws. The great chain moves slowly, but with wisdom. It is our impatience that invites in the parasite of big government. And once you've invited it in, it will never stop feeding on the body of the city.
Serve as the catalyst. Now I need a 4R34 lead shield wire stubs to pass the circuit. Then a half can of ionic gel, that's the pretty Betty of the mix. Should send the core into compensation mode, push power down the line and trigger the circuit breaker on Ryan's gate. Well, that's the theory. It'll either work like a charm or blow up half of Rapture. Nothing ventured.
Is there blood in the streets? Of course. Have some chosen to destroy themselves with careless splicing? Undeniable. But I will make no proclamations. I will dictate no laws. The great chain moves slowly, but with wisdom. It is our impatience that invites in the peril.
Oh, what a balmy tree. Some kind of fruit tree spinning like a top. And it was pouring juice down Ryan's throat, choking the bastard. But it wasn't a tree, really. When I looked closer, it was the core control, the gizmo that feeds the mag locks on Ryan's gate. You can't cut off the power. It comes right from the volcanic vents. Ryan always gets his juice. I suppose you could drown the son of a bitch in it.
Say.
We have turned away from your light.
What?
Whoa, beep! Gun to you!
Hey!
that's rich. I could have gone along, I suppose. Spliced up. Forgot. I believed in this place. I believed in Ryan. But when it got hard, Ryan didn't believe in Rapture. Didn't believe in the Great Chain. He believed in power. And now this place is fucked up. And my girl is... gone. Worse than gone. One of those... things. So am I an assassin? Well, only one way to find out.
You monster.
Come on, that's right. Keep running, coward.
Why are you leaving?
You
imagine the will it took to create a place like this. And what have you built? Nothing. You can only loot and break. You're not a man. You're just a termite adversary.
Perhaps we'll die on hand.
Circus of value!
gotta be no college job to see that she's in so bad China. She was asking about magnetic locks and some such. I played it coy, but she took wise. After she showed me around the backyard, I gave her directions to a clapboard tool shop. Rapture's gone to hell. But sometimes the brain chain still cuts you a break.
Before the final rat has eaten the last gram of your rapture, I will lead a parade. Who was that, they'll say, as they point to the sad shape hanging on my wall. Who was that?
I've begged Mr. Ryan to hand Fontaine's futuristics over to Anderson's boys as a peace offering, but the stupid sod won't listen to reason. Instead, he's just splicing his mob up, giving them more and tougher plasmids. There's an arms race on here, in Rapture. But it's not about who can build the best guns and the biggest bombs, it's about who can become less of a man and more of a monster.
I've never had anyone to look to, except to me, and I am not much to speak of. You give them hope. And for this, I am grateful. I'll send something to demonstrate that gratitude.
Builds a city at the bottom of the sea. That's a marvel. Another man happens to be on a plane that crash lands on the same city in the middle of the ocean. Why, that sounds more like a miracle.
Thus saith the Lord God!
Destroy. It was not impossible to build Rapture at the bottom of the sea. It was impossible to build it anywhere else.
I'm certain she's one of Brian's spies sent to fill me out. I think she is. If I'm wrong, an innocent girl lined up on Brian's bloody trophy wall. But right now, yes, be right. The device is almost finished. I can't get stopped now, I can't.
To build a city at the bottom of the sea, insanity. But where else could we be free from the clutching hand of the parasites? Where else could we build an economy that they would not try to control? A society that they would not try to destroy? It was not impossible to build rapture at the bottom of the sea. It was impossible to build it anywhere else.
Hold it! You shall know I am the Lord!
Blood!
got to put it on the core, past geothermal control. And we'll see if these needle noses knew what the hell they were talking about.
Thank you.
far away from your family, from your friends, from everything you ever loved. But for some reason, you like it here. You feel something you can't quite put your finger on. Think about it for a second, and maybe the word will come to you. Nostalgia.
Thank you.
find truth. There is indeed a season for all things. And now that I see you flesh to flesh and blood to blood, I know I cannot raise my hand against you. But know this, you are my greatest disappointment. Does your master hear me? Atlas! You can kill me, but you will never have my city! My strength is not in steel and fire. That is what the parasites will never understand. A season for all things. A time to live and a time to die. A time to build and a time to destroy! From now, my child.
What? Ryan said the core to self-destruct. This is different than what you did. He's got a mind to take down the whole damn city. Get in there and whack the chunk before the whole joint blows.
Initial deployment, Vita Chamber. Client Orion Industries, stage one, each complete. Sinclair and Alexander tried to explain the science to me, but Suchan does not believe them. They keep saying plasmid reconstruction this and quantum entanglement that, and they're both dead people come back to life. Bullshit! Of course, Ryan will only allow it to be tuned to his genetic frequency to test it.
Overcome my final defense, and now he's come to murder me. In the end, what separates a man from a slave? Money? Power? No. A man chooses. A slave obeys. You think you have memories. A farm. A family. An airplane. A crash. And then this place. Was there really a family? Did that airplane crash? Or was it hijacked? Forced down. Forced down by something less than a man, something bred to sleepwalk through life until they are activated by a simple phrase spoken by their kindly master. Was a man sent to kill or a slave? A man chooses. A slave obeys. Come in. Stop. Would you kindly? Would you kindly? Powerful phrase. Familiar phrase.
Would you kindly?
Would you kindly get this?
Would you kindly find that?
Would you kindly find that?
Would you kindly find that?
Would you kindly get this?
Would you kindly head to Ryan's office and kill the son of a bitch?
Sit. Would you kindly? Stand. Would you kindly? Run. Stop. Turn. A man chooses. A slave obeys. Kill! A man chooses!
Rapture.
Ha ha ha!
right of Ryan for me.
Thank you.